This lecture is about the influence of friction on the flow properties, viscous flows, and the boundary layer concept. Let us start with D'Alembert's paradox. Jean Laurent D'Alembert was a French mathematician. In 1768, some 80 years after Isaac Newton presented an entire book on fluid dynamics, he applied the equations of motion on an incompressible, frictionless flow past a two-dimensional body and found the drag to be zero. D'Alembert also performed measurements, and he found that there was drag, and that it was proportional to the square of the velocity. So he knew that his calculations were wrong. But why? The answer is because of friction. The difference lies in a very thin layer of fluid that moves along the surface of an object affected by friction, the boundary layer. The name of a very famous aerodynamicist is connected to the concept of the boundary layer, and we will talk about that later. For a long time, this paradox remained unresolved. Only about 50 years later, in the early 19th century, the effect of friction on the flow of fluids was properly formulated by a Frenchman called Claude-Louis Navier and an Englishman born in Ireland called George Stokes. Their set of differential equations is still known today as the Navier-Stokes equations. In practice, solving these equations analytically is much too difficult. Only with modern computers, it becomes possible to solve mostly approximations and simplifications of these equations. This is the domain of CFD, computational fluid dynamics. Now back to the 19th century. In 1842, Osborne Reynolds was born in Belfast, Ireland. Already at a very young age, Osborne Reynolds liked mathematics and mechanics. He graduated at Cambridge University, and he was a bright man, and despite his lack of experience, at the age of 26, he was appointed professor to the chair of engineering at what was to become the University of Manchester. His most important work, and the major contribution to the understanding of the concepts of fluid flow, was published in 1883. It was about experiments he had performed on water flowing through pipes. A drawing of the setup and more in detail of the pipe flow that Reynolds made are shown here. They appeared in his original paper. Reynolds introduced dye into the flow through pipes just before the water enters the bell mouth of the pipe. He found that, depending on the flow speed, the dye filament would either flow neatly and smoothly through the pipe, a laminar flow, or at some point in the pipe would become unstable and fill the entire pipe, a turbulent flow. He also found that this transition from laminar to turbulent flow takes place when the parameter, defined by density times speed times pipe diameter over viscosity, would exceed the critical value of 2,300. This non-dimensional parameter is called the Reynolds number. It also has a physical meaning. The Reynolds number is proportional to the ratio of the inertia, or mechanical forces, to the viscous forces in the flow. It governs many aspects of viscous flow, like boundary layer thickness, skin friction drag, transition, etc. The man who is considered to be the father of modern aerodynamics is Ludwig Prandtl. Prandtl was born in Bavaria, in Germany, in 1875. He made contributions to various fields of science, such as plasticity and meteorology. But his most important achievement in fluid dynamics is the boundary layer concept he presented in 1904. Later that year, he was appointed director of the Institute for Technical Physics at Göttingen University in Germany, where he would stay until his death in 1953. Until the end of the Second World War, this institute was very famous and the world leader in the field of aerodynamics. Göttingen University had a variety of wind tunnels, and this enabled Prandtl and his students to conduct many experiments on transition, separation, wing aerodynamics, compressibility effects, and supersonic flow. Prandtl had many students who later became renowned researchers of themselves, in various fields of aerodynamics, like Heinrich Blasius, Hermann Schlichting, Theodor von Karman, Jacob Eckeret, and others. Prandtl divided the flow field around an object into two distinct regions. A region near the surface that is affected by friction, the boundary layer, and a region further away from the surface in which friction could be neglected. Since the fluid adheres to the surface, the velocity at the surface is zero. The boundary layer will have a velocity profile going from zero at the surface to the undisturbed free stream velocity at a distance delta from the surface, the boundary layer thickness. So, finally, 136 years after D'Alembert presented his contradiction, Prandtl provided the theory to tackle this paradox. And remember, Bernoulli's principle was derived for frictionless flow, so it is not valid in the boundary layer.